So the other day I was at the airport and this woman sits down next to me. And when I say next to me, I mean this is her butt. This is my butt. Our butts were touching. Like our butts were almost one. And I'm like, lady, why must you sit so close to me? I do not want to feel the warmth of your butt. Stop it. Just get over. No, but it wasn't bad enough that she was basically sitting on my lap. She starts talking. And I think she's talking to me at first. She's like,
hello?
I'm like, hi. How's it going? She looked at me with a snobby little look, like,
wasn't talking to you, ho.
I'm thinking, lady, you're the one that's sitting on my lap. I was being nice to say hello to you. And then she proceeds to go on and start having a conversation. And I'm still sort of thinking that she's talking to me, but she wasn't.
You're never gonna believe this because I can't even believe it either. Like, I seriously.
The thing with LA is you're never actually sure if people are really on their headsets or not. They're either doing one of a few things, talking on the phone, two, they're reciting lines for an audition, or three, they're just absolutely crazy and they're talking to themselves. Then comes the conversation that I thought would never ever end. Those of you guys that are old enough to remember the Lamb Chop sing-along,
the song that doesn't end.
Kind of something like that just goes on and on and on. I know so much about her that I'm pretty sure that if we're Facebook friends, I'm gonna know every one of her status updates because she basically just told me an entire recap of her entire timeline from the day that she was born. Most importantly, I learned about her recent diagnosis with the diabetes.
I can't even believe it. Like, I just got diagnosed with diabetes. Yeah, the diabetes.
Yes, the diabetes. That's what she was saying. She repeated it so many times that everyone in the entire airport from here to New York is probably well aware of her new diabetes. She peed so many times last night.
Every time that I walked downstairs, I was just like, I gotta pee. What were you like? I was like, I gotta pee. I was like, girl, you gotta pee.
I don't care. I don't even think the other person on the other end of the line cares at this point because this is just gibber, 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 gibber.
Between the times of 5 and approximately like 7:30 a.m., I was super tired.
Jibber, jabber, jibber, 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 jabber.
You'll never believe what I got my cat for Christmas.
It's not even Christmas. It's freaking August.
It's this really sparkly Swarovski diamond necklace.
Jibber, jibber, diabetes, jabber, jabber, jabber. I peed so many times.
Decided that, well, I just don't even know.
Now at Southwest, there is an open seating policy. So basically you just board and pick a seat. Well, guess who decided to sit next to me? That's right. Out of all of the seats on this plane, you had to plop right down and touch my butt again. No escaping. My question to you guys is, how would you have escaped the situation? Because truthfully, I don't think there was any way to escape. I mean, I am the kind of person that really likes to hold my emotions in and then when I get home, make a video about it because I don't really like confrontation. Anyway, if you guys happen to find yourself being extremely loud on your telephone, just remember to maybe turn it down. But I have a feeling that a lot of you guys are like me and you don't actually ever really talk on the phone. I hate the phone so much that I removed the phone icon from my main iPhone home screen and deactivated my voicemail. But that's a whole nother story. All right, I'm gonna go. I love you guys. Don't forget to subscribe so you'll see when I post a new video and be sure to check out the rest of my YouTube channels. Well, they're everywhere. I'll see you guys later. Bye.
I am deciding that I'm not gonna celebrate Christmas this year because